Sunday afternoon, we were working inside, and it all came up really fast. We had small hail, and then within about 10 seconds, it was golf ball size hail. And then we saw the tree, that tree, whipping around, and I said to my father-in-law, we better get in the basement. So we ran downstairs, and it only seemed like about 10 or 15 seconds, and it was done.
I jumped out of bed and started to leave the bedroom, but the air conditioner was coming through the window towards me. So I started pushing it back in, but I realized there was a train on the other side pushing the air conditioner. So I stepped aside real quick and I did about two flips right across the room and into the wall on the other side of the bedroom. I think I'd be blind today if I'd stayed behind that air conditioner.
I work at a Sifto evaporator plant in Goderich, and I was at work at the time. I went out to my truck and got a section of the paper, and I pulled into the, I call it the tent, but it's a cover-all building, a big building we keep product in. And I started reading the paper, and I saw hail start, so I thought I better get back into the building, just because I have a glass roof on my lift truck, and I didn't want to get it broken. I had no idea what was coming, so I drove out of the tent, a short distance to the plant, up the ramp, and by the time I got to the middle of the four big bay doors where the truck's back in, the doors were coming in on me. So I exited my lift truck and grabbed onto a steel beam with one hand, I think, and covered my head with the other hand, and it all broke loose. The roof started coming down all around me, the doors all flew in, any glass in the place was gone. I, for some reason, took a quick peek out, and I saw my co-worker's SUV lift into the air, turn, and come into the bay. So after I saw that, I just put my head down, and it was over in a matter of seconds.
I mean, this is a pretty small community. I'll admit I've been here my entire life, so I haven't had too much experience taking pictures of, I guess, terrible things, you could say. But I mean, the first time taking pictures of, you know, families like walking out of their houses with whatever they can find and like just sitting on curbs crying because they have nothing left. I mean, it's, what do you say? It's an eye opener, man. Thank you.
day. Wide awake, you serenade. A silent sigh for spacious skies. Awake, oh songs. Bleeding, deeply bleeding. All we see is over.
It started with a strange cloud over the lake. I was riding my bike along the beach, and I looked up at it, stopped to snap a photo. That's ominous, I thought. A stark line of rain came in fast, and I turned for home, but I got caught and soaked as the sky darkened even more. I got inside in time to hear the sound. A strange, high, whistling hum, and behind that, a roar, a freight train. The sky was black. Hail pounded the windows and the trees whipped and bent almost double. I stood at the window and watched, dirt, leaves, branches whirling around the house, and I thought, this is what a tornado looks like from the inside, but it couldn't be. We don't get tornadoes here. And just like that, the storm was over. Everything was back to normal, I thought. I jumped in the car and drove across town to pick my daughter up at work, but it took 45 minutes. Trees were down at every corner of my part of town. Trees on houses, across the roads, sidewalks broken open, roots in the air. And the acrid tang of gas filled the air as I drove in from Zaire's on Highway 8, and I knew that I had been wrong. It was a tornado. And I could see now exactly where it went. North of Highway 8 looked like World War II. I made it back home, twisting and turning through a maze of debris, siding, boards, branches, trees, hydro poles and power lines, people crying and holding each other, and houses torn apart. A guy at one corner was directing traffic. His face white and his eyes wide. I asked him if he was okay and he shook his head. No. I saw the square, he said. It's ruined. Later, we sat quiet in the darkest night our town has ever seen and waited for the sun to rise on a Goderich that we knew would never be the same.
Okay, folks, I really want to welcome you on behalf of Council to Out of the Storm. It's fantastic what we're doing here, and we owe a lot of thanks to the many volunteers. And, you know, every penny will end up going to the Goderich Disaster Relief Fund, and I really think that's so important. But we will rebuild bigger than better, and we will be stronger. God bless you all. We will rebuild. We will be stronger. We will rebuild. We will rebuild. We will be stronger. We will rebuild. God bless you all. Bless you all. We will rebuild. We will be stronger. We will rock you.